through the first cutscene. Alright, dick shot. I think we'll play through the cutscenes.
In the waning months of the Clone Wars, the 501st faced missions critical to the agenda of Chancellor Palpatine. When we arrived at the bombed-out ruins of Mygeetto, our Jedi commander believed we had been sent to take out a droid energy collector. What Ki-Adi Mundi didn't know, however, was that our unit of the 501st was really after an experimental Mygeetan power source that the Chancellor wanted for his super laser.
Probably should have put two and two together.
Keeping Mundi in the dark wasn't easy. The Jedi had become increasingly wary of the Chancellor's doings, and were on the lookout for the slightest hint of treachery. Just like the rest of them, though, he never caught whiff of what was really going on until it was far too late.
Alright. Alright, men. Today's target is an energy collector on the northern section of the platform. If we can take it down, production facilities in the area will grind to a halt.
Got him.
Let's move him out. The enemy's forward command post is on the other side of this bridge. We'll have to capture it before moving on.
Let's turn this place into a scrap pile.
Space for General Mundi to land. Take out those turrets and clear the deck. One more to go.
Yep.
Listen up, man. Before we can begin our assault on the energy collector, we have to get past the shield barricade. Get behind the shield and take out the generator. Capture the CP. Will serve as an excellent lookout point for our mission.
That tank does not see me, right? It sees me.
Listen up. Before we can begin our assault on the SEP's energy collector, we have to penetrate their shield barricade. So load up and move out. Take down the core shield by destroying the generator.
Alright, let's do some speedrun strats here.
Good work. Now collect the core samples and return them to the dropship on the other side of the bridge. Now take the crystals back to the dropship. Nicely done, gentlemen. Your work here today has made the Chancellor a very happy man.
Dropship hasn't even let touchdown. There it is. Damn. Alrighty.
The success of the mission on Mygeetto was something of a revelation for the men of the 501st.
Yep.
Suddenly, we realized that the Jedi could be fooled. And if they could be fooled,
they could be kissed. I mean, killed. What? So we'll we'll do that, you know.
As the Clone Wars progressed, more and more ground-based legions found themselves pressed into space combat, including the fighting forces of the 501st. For months, every hour of our downtime was spent in the simulator, preparing for the time we would face our enemies from the cockpit of a 170. Finally, the day came to earn our wings. The CIS had staged a daring kidnapping of Chancellor Palpatine and was being escorted from Coruscant by a fleet of separatist ships. With only a few veteran pilots on planet, many of the 501st were pressed into service to drive off the Seps and buy time for a pair of Jedi Knights to rescue the Chancellor.
Yeah, I gotta get...
Control to pilots. Prep your ships for battle.
Gotta get
pilots and Marines, get to your ships. The Jedi are depending on you. Incoming fighters, take them out.
Right. Weird, though.
Vulture behind you! Don't let him get a lock!
Okay.
Ship acting as a frigate for the droids. Destroy it.
There's no goddamn way.
Pilots, focus your fire on the main CIS ships. We need their shields down as quickly as possible.
Some grenades. 3.
Now, grab a fighter and destroy the bridge of the enemy cruiser.
Okay. Just die a few times, and then you get one good life. That's what they meant by that, right?
After disabling the final capital ship, General Kenobi and Skywalker took advantage of the opportunity we'd created and rescued the Chancellor. Took all the credit, too.
Hey, that was on Mustafar. They shot that little scene. Okay. Heart of Darkness.
It's been said that the 501st got the best of the war. We also got the worst.
Yeah.
On Felucia, the Seps dug their metal heels into the muck of that alien hellhole and dared the Republic to come in after them. So we did.
Yeah.
Only to be met with the month after month of flesh-eating diseases, shrieking nocturnal predators, and other sights that haunt me to this day. Cut off and for all we knew, abandoned by our superiors, our only hope was Aayla Secuda, our Jedi commander.
Yeah.
Without her iron will, none of us would have come out of that mess with our sanity or our lives. When her death came, I hope it was quick. She earned that much.
She's quick enough, you know.
Our Ford unit is under attack by some kind of creatures. Get up there and give them some support.
What is that thing? Stop! These things are everywhere! Where are they? Oh no, they're all dead!
This ATTE is out of commission.
Movement to the north!
Right.
Here they come. Wipe out these creatures before they rip our unit apart.
Hey. This way? Oh, Jesus. Jesus fucking Christ. Ha! Get fucked. Oh yeah, that's right, my guys don't count towards, the death of the Acolytes. I suck at this. Okay, I'm not gonna miss. What did I tell you? Oh boy.
Those things are tough to take down. Two more to go. Nice work. Just one more. CIS units have been detected moving in this direction. Defend the ATTE until Jedi Master Secuda arrives.
Lay down some It's probably going to be all for naught, but oh well.
Has landed. A Republic gunship crashed in the brush near here. Acquire its power cell and bring it back to reactivate the ATTE. Nice work. The ATTE has been reactivated. The CIS offensive is being mounted from the fungal tree to the south. Advance on their base of operations there, and take out their primary defense turrets.
For the Republic!
Alright, just gonna come up here. Just let that Declay do its thing.
When the 501st was finally rotated out of Felucia, Ayla Secuda made a point of seeing us off personally, calling us the bravest soldiers she had ever seen. It's a good thing we were wearing helmets, because none of us could bear to look her in the eye.
Wait, did I die? Oh, shit. I did die. Ah, damn it. Oh well, at least it was under 5 minutes. I think. Okay. Let's attack this space.
When the Separatists' invasion of Kashyyyk caught the Republic flat-footed, a detachment of the 501st was sent in to stop the bleeding until reinforcements could arrive.
Yep.
It was a textbook suicide mission and we knew it. As we fought our way into Kashyyyk's atmosphere, most of us believed that the only way we'd be getting off this planet was in a body bag.
Okay.
Not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill.
The droids have put up a blockade around Kashyyyk. If we're going to punch through, we'll need to weaken their forces. Pilots, focus your attacks on their support ships.
They've launched a transport!
I'm just gonna...
They're using bombers.
Alright, first kill was done by a rocket. Let's go.
Pilots on deck.
Can we fly in this ship? is it still out of... Yeah, it's still out of commission. Any port in a storm?
Heavy turrets.
And I guess there were shotguns in space, but you don't get the.
One more.
Get them till this mission.
Great.
Well done, pilot. Head back to the hangar for your next objective.
Go dying.
Pilot, we need you to take an LAAT into the enemy hangar, land it, and destroy the ship's internal systems.
As many reinforcements as we can.
Control to pilots. Prep your ships for battle.
Roger that. Take down that TIE fighter!
Systems and destroy their fuel and life support systems.
All right. rifle, this one, would be greatly helpful, but unfortunately it's rockets only. It's not rifles only until later.
As the 501st finally broke through the Sept blockade over Kashyyyk, I took a long look back at the battle that continued to rage over the planet, and wondered why so many had to die for a bunch of walking carpets.
Well,
then I followed my orders and turned planetward.
I'm not gonna lie, it's just such a juicy target for a rocket. Yeah, I'm just saying.
When we arrived on Kashyyyk, things were just as bad as we feared. The droids had us outgunned, outmaneuvered, and outmanned by a 5-to-1 margin. What none of us had counted on was the Wookiees.
Line in the sand, that's what I mean.
We'd all heard the stories, of course, but we'd never fought next to them. Never seen them rip apart a droid with their bare hands. They were magnificent. Even so, it was still a suicide mission. At least it was until Master Yoda arrived. Then it became a battle. A winnable battle.
I'm gonna need to get a fan in here or something.
This is it, men. We have to hold this beachhead until reinforcements arrive. No retreats, no excuses.
Alright. the unseen rockets that kill you.
We must protect the Wookiee base.
We did not make it past that wall. You know what? I'm just gonna let you have a field day with that.
At all costs.
Okay.
If we don't, this whole place is going to blow. Without choosing the thing. Seriously? Thank you.
right, I don't think they'll blow up the oil refinery.
Push forward and send them packing.
Proud I am to stand by Wookiees in their hour of need.
Alright. Yeah, that super battle droid almost killed me, so, you know, there's not a lot of high hopes with this Yoda. Slash attack really works when they're all standing in a straight fucking line. And they don't move in any way, shape, or form.
Our reinforcements are being depleted.
Since he wanted to sneak up on me by being in direct line of sight. And you get the special treatment of a rocket to the face.
Fight another day.
Oh. That droid was not happy with me placing the explosives on their tank. They're like, the fuck you doing?
The timely arrival of Master Yoda, the 501st was able to hold the line against the Seps on Kashyyyk.
Alright.
We left as heroes. Years later, we'd return as conquerors.
Ignore the fact that I died 6 times. Let's go to Uta Pau with Daddy One Kenobi.
In our bones, we knew the war was almost over. The galaxy held its breath, waiting to see which side would make the final daring move. As fortune would have it, the Republic moved first. After the Chancellor informed the Jedi Council that General Grievous and the Sept leaders were hiding on Utapau, General Kenobi gathered an army large enough to capture three star systems.
Yeah, that line attack.
When the orders reached the 501st, our morale soared. For better or worse, this would be the beginning of the end.
In a row.
There is a two-story building just a bit southwest of your position. Assault that command post.
You got it.
Alright.
Capture the CP. Will serve as an excellent lookout point for our mission. Further down the highway. Clear any enemies on the highway and secure the area. Send in a dropship to back you up. General Obi-Wan has landed on this level. He should be able to help you troopers quite a bit.
Alright. Yeah, they got a sniper way over there, and they have a beat on me. Honestly, they're so far away that I can't even see them half the time.
By the Force, General Grievous is stationed in Hangar 10. Take him out before he wipes out our force.
Okay. Got him.
Grievous is retreating. Well done. There's some AA guns in Hangar 10 that are causing our flyboys quite a bit of trouble. They need you to destroy those guns. Then they're gonna land the heavy support units. Nice work. Destroy the other gun and Hangar 10 will be ours. Stand by for heavy support unit, soldier. Tanks are incoming. Now, soldier, destroy that energy tower.
Okay.
The death of General Grievous at the hands of General Kenobi, the Utapau raid had broken the back of the Separatists. Under normal circumstances, it would have been a time for celebration. But our next orders put paid to those thoughts.
Yeah, that was zero death. And unless I was Obi-Wan for 3.5 minutes, take a shot. Alright, back in Coruscant. Operation Nightfall. This is some reverent shit right here.
What I remember about the rise of the Empire is how quiet it was. During the waning hours of the Clone Wars, the 501st Legion was discreetly transferred back to Coruscant. It was a silent trip. We all knew what was about to happen, what we're about to do. Did we have any doubts? Any private, traitorous thoughts? Perhaps, but no one said a word. Not on the flight to Coruscant, not when Order 66 came down, and not when we marched into the Jedi Temple. Not a word.
The Jedi is at hand. We have been directed by the highest authority to wipe out the insurgent Jedi Order that threatens our great empire. Our first objective is to capture the Council Chamber. Lord Vader will be our field commander. Let's keep the Jedi low and move out. To the library. The Jedi are attempting to destroy the library's holo box in direct defiance of command. Stop them. Stop the destruction of the Jedi holo box. If you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes, command will scan the contents of the library. What I remember about the rise of the Empire is how quiet it was during the waning hours of the close.
Yeah, I've seen that, so.
Tonight, the fall of the Jedi is at hand. We have been directed by the highest authority to wipe out the insurgent Jedi Order that threatens our great Empire. Our first objective is to capture the Council Chamber. Lord Vader will be our field commander. Let's keep the Jedi low and move out. Defiance of command. Stop them. Stop the destruction of the Jedi holo books. If you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes, command can scan the contents of the library.
Going over here.
Objectives are a pair of holocrons, rumored to contain the sum of Sith and Jedi knowledge. The first one is located on the comm room. Retrieve it and bring it to the veranda.
Oh god, I'm about to die.
Students against the Empire. Let them bear witness to the cost of rebellion. Well done. Our new Emperor will be pleased. Primary mission objectives complete. The Jedi Temple is being secured.
Coruscant and the elimination of the traitorous Jedi, Palpatine's rise to power was complete. In recognition of our service and loyalty to the Emperor, the 501st were placed under the direct command of Lord Vader. Armed with deadly new weapons, blazing new ships, and shiny new armor, our presence let the galaxy know that the days of the Old Republic...
I'm just gonna skip over that.
Yeah, we're all evil now, blah, blah, blah. Alright. Imperial diplomacy.
During the rise of the Empire, the Emperor's home planet of Naboo rapidly established itself as a major irritant. After a number of Naboo's ambassadors were sent home in various states of dismemberment, her newly elected queen broke off diplomatic ties and began exploring military options. Clearly, it was time for a regime change, a change that would be affected by the 501st, now under the direct command of Darth Vader. Our orders were simple, to infiltrate the city, take out their leader, sending a clear signal to other potential troublemakers in the Empire.
Okay, let's start throwing down some landmines everywhere.
Welcome to the capital city of Theed. Tonight, we will be performing a radical destabilization of the Theed government via the elimination of their queen. She is heavily guarded in the central plaza by a group of Jedi and an auto-turret grid. In order to defeat these defenses, we must set up a perimeter around the central plaza and shut down the auto-turret grid. Careful, soldier. Your numbers are few, and the mission's success rests on your shoulders.
Come on! I'm still there!
Send him over. Got him.
Now it's onto the Embassy Plaza. Move out!
Really? Can't have him follow me because he just threw out a recon droid that is immune to all things.
So good. Now capture the guard post past the embassy. If he needs an extra firepower, we've managed to sneak a tank for you at the embassy command post. Use it wisely.
Alrighty.
The auto-turret grid console, clearing access to the central plaza. Destroy it, and the Queen will be ours. The Queen's personal Jedi bodyguards have broken from the palace. Destroy them. Watch out, soldier. The auto-turret grid is still online. Keep you and your men out of the central plaza.
Sorry, I thought something was up. Alright, never mind. Back to it.
The Queen and her her royal guard are trying to escape. Quickly. You must eliminate the Queen at all costs.
For the Empire. The Queen's death will serve as an example to other nascent rebellions, saving countless lives. That's a victory drink.
With the Queen eliminated, Naboo quickly fell in line. It was the first time the 501st was called upon to adjust a planet's government.
Yeah.
But it wouldn't be the last. Within months, the 501st gained a well-deserved reputation as Vader's Fist.
All right, if I didn't die that one time, it might have been a shot round. Probably, yeah, it probably would have been a shot round. Tying up loose ends. Preventative measures. Because it could mean his...
Although the Clone Wars were over, some people never seemed to get the message. The worst case of denial was Gisor Delso, a Geonosian separatist who'd somehow escaped Lord Vader's efforts to wipe out the remnants of the CIS. Lord Vader tracked him to Mustafar and brought us in to finish the job. It seemed like a simple enough mission. But when we saw the fleet of droid ships hovering over the planet, we suddenly realized that Delso's denial mechanisms were a little more dangerous than we'd imagined.
Yeah. The other thing I was going to say is preventative measures of us not having another fucking...
Sir, the droids have landed on our ship. We can't launch our fighters.
Calm down, pilot. Get out there and destroy that transport. Use any means necessary to clear the hangar.
Really? No kill. So, you know. Did we get it? Nah, we didn't get it.
We are under attack.
All right, men. Now get into your fighters and give those droids all you've got. Destroy their fighters and bombers. Watch out for the asteroids, pilots. They're easy to destroy, but that doesn't mean they aren't dangerous.
Radar non-operational. Switching to manual.
Bombers. And, you know, die.
Now hear this. All hands, man your battle station.
Yeah, there's still...
You picked up a bomber.
A bunch of droids in our ship. Thank you.
Bomber to deliver the maximum damage.
Alright, I'm gonna fire off some bombs. I'm definitely not dying this ship, you know. It's just that happened. Seriously. Okay, this is why we were running out of troops. Yeah, this is just an executive decision. To take out some of these fucking droids.
Land in the enemy's hangar, steal one of their strike bombers, and return it to our hangar. Get moving, pilots.
I tried to do evasive maneuvers, but it didn't work.
All hands, man your battle station.
Ow. Yeah, that was a bad turn, so I knew a fucking joke.
Most pleased.
Alright, take a drink for that, because goddamn.
The slight whiff of nostalgia the 501st had enjoyed fighting the droid fleet over Mustafar had already grown sour by the time we'd established orbital positions. Now it was time to find out what this was all about.
Alright, let's go down and kill some buds. 98 fucking times. Alright, we'll save. Tying up loose ends.
By the time we'd made our way to the molten surface of Mustafar, it was apparent that Delso had been a busy little bug. All by his lonesome, he'd found a previously hidden droid factory, fired it up, and cranked out his own private army of battle droids. Needless to say, this got the men of the 501st a little hot under the helmet, and not just because of all that lava.
Yeah.
Truth be told, we'd all had our fill of those gearheads during the war. We couldn't stomach the thought of going through another one. So we blew them up. Blew up the droids, blew up the factory. Damn near blew up the planet.
Can you tell that I've played this way too many times?
All right, troops. Today we stamp out final remnants of the CIS. Eventually we'll be blowing up a hidden droid factory. But for now, we need to infiltrate and secure that nearby mining facility. Move them out. Take control of the lava observation room.
Alright. Let's lay off the pistol for a little bit. Ha! Got him.
Base looks like a good place to make a stand. Capture it!
Daddy Kenobi, do not let us die. Helping me capture this. Literally all of them are coalescing at that hallway. I don't even know why anymore. Because it ain't here, that's for damn sure.
Destroy today will come back to haunt us tomorrow.
All
wipe
right.
them out. These Geonosians have been working on a new Confederate
okay.
infantry prototype. Destroy the schematics before they can use them to build a new droid army.
Let us go. Can somebody open up this door for me, please?
One of our boys got killed bringing the other beacon. Go out and retrieve it. Get that beacon to the central antenna.
Alrighty. Okay. Try not to die. Oh god. Why are there so many guys following?
Pull back to the collection base and watch the fireworks.
Raining box!
Kill them all! Dizor Delta has been defeated. Scratch one droid rebellion.
I only partly planned that. It just spawns in, just boom! Can't even make that shit up.
The destruction of the mining facility put an end to any thoughts of a second droid rebellion. For the first time in years, the men of the 501st could relax and get about the business of maintaining an empire rather than building one.
Stats died 4 times. Yeah, you kill me twice, I kill you 8 times, motherfucker. Alright. Let's go kill some of our brothers from another master.
Officially, there never was a clone rebellion on Kamino.
Okay.
Unofficially, approximately 20 years after we were created, a special detachment of the Imperial 501st Legion was dispatched to Kamino with orders to eradicate an army of clones that had been bred to take arms against the Empire. Our mission commander, an expert on the inner workings of Kamino, was a young bounty hunter named Boba Fett.
Yeah, so we get to fly around as Bobber.
Let's get this over with.
Boba Fett has been chosen to lead a small task force into the Kamino Cloning Center. His familiarity with the center's layout and access codes should give us the element of surprise. Before we leave, the Empire wants us to collect some DNA samples from our evil
All
brothers.
Right. Who wants some fire? You want some fire? Yeah.
Back to ship immediately.
Okay. Let's try not to die. That'd be a good thing.
Sample secure. Pulling ship back to a safe distance. Good job. Now take that CP and await further orders.
Yeah, this would be a lot easier with Boba Fett, but he's not gonna spawn no more, so.
Keeping the Kaminoans clone pods alive before they can create any more traitorous anti-troopers.
Time spent as a hero, you know what I mean?
Their transport before they can escape.
Gunship.
I think that's the last we'll be seeing of those guys.
victory. Probably gonna have to top off my drink.
The bounty hunter left after the battle was over. He said something about tracking down a smuggler on Tatooine. After the Kamino uprising, the Emperor decided that an army of genetically identical soldiers was too susceptible to corruption. Future troopers would be cloned from a variety of templates. Though the 501st itself remained pure, the rest of the Imperial Army gradually became more and more diverse. We never really got used to the new guys.
After 9. I don't see us going further than 9 with this campaign, so might wanna keep going, might wanna stop. I don't know. What do y'all think?
Once it was finally finished, the Death Star was the Emperor's favorite toy. It was also the most boring assignment in the galaxy for a stormtrooper. Tedious inspection drills, endless hours of guarding impregnable force field generators. Things got so bad that when a prison break erupted in the cell block, we were almost happy to have someone shooting at us again. If only we'd known what an embarrassing snipe storm we were about to wade into, we probably would have jettisoned the whole detention block into space.
I would have done that too.
Attention, Hangar 84G. There is a prison riot in progress. A contingent of the 501st is inbound from an exterior inspection. Join up with the squad mates in the hangar and quell this riot. Rebel forces are converging on Hangar 84G. We cannot allow any of them to escape. Defend the hangar.
Take out the officer!
Secure. The riot originated in cell block 2180. Get up there and secure that cell block. One of the rebels managed to get his hands on the plans for this battle station. Cannot allow those plans to leave this outpost.
Right.
Dispatch the rebel carrying the plans and return them to our forces.
Let us go and continue with the
Well done. The plans have been secured. The prisoners have captured the fire control room. You must not allow them to damage the main cannon.
What? Alright, that was close. Oh boy. Need to make sure not to blow up both sides of the control panels.
Is ours. The rebels have infiltrated Hangar 85G and are preparing to escape in one of the shuttles. Get to the hangar and take out that shuttle before it takes off.
Alright, let's utilize our rockets for that. Jump looked real close.
Jedi in the TIE hangar. He is the source of this rebellion. Destroy this man. Now.
Drink for the death and drink for the
rebel
danger.
Leader has been destroyed. Our reinforcements can take it from here. The uprising has been crushed. Well done, trooper. Lord Vader will be most pleased with your performance.
You say that you'll be most pleased, but I don't think we actually... I don't think he was actually very pleased with us letting this...
After the embarrassment of the prison break, Lord Vader removed us from our comfortable belay and began dragging the 501st across the galaxy in a dangerous hunt for the now missing Death Star plans. Ironically, our punishment eventually proved to be our salvation. The poor souls who took our place in the detention area were completely wiped out when the Death Star was destroyed.
Only died once. Yeah, it wouldn't have been a shot round anyways. Alright, let's go to Polis Mossa.
By the time of the raid on Polis Mossa, the men of the 501st were starting to get a little sick of the so-called rebellion. In the past, we'd secretly enjoyed putting down a local insurrection or two. They kept the troops sharp and the Empire feared. But these rebels were different. They were organized, they were growing, and they were everywhere. The raid on Polis Mossa was a perfect example of how things were starting to fall apart. We were supposed to go in, wipe out a small band of rebels, and recover some stolen Imperial plans on an encrypted holodisk. Before we knew it, we were nearly overrun by rebel forces, with the holodisk nowhere to be found.
Let's go recover some floppy disks.
All right, men, Lord Vader wants this raid done by the book. Our first objective is the comm center, just beyond this hangar.
Yes.
time to make our way to the base command building on the far side of the facility. If our intelligence is right, along the way we'll find a rebel holodisk containing some very important plans. It'll take time to realign the comm dish and transmit the data from the holodisk. You'll have to hold off the rebels until the transmission is complete. Do not let the comm facility fall into enemy hands. Deep within the caverns of this complex, the rebels have a data bank that holds Imperial encryption codes that can be used to eavesdrop on our ship-to-ship communications. Make your way to the caverns and destroy the data bank. I've got good news and bad news. The good news is it's time to get off this dreary rock. The bad news is the rebels have taken over the hangars. You'll have to fight our way out.
Die or get the tank. I died. Not after killing a bunch of their guys. Smart ass dodging my rockets. Posts.
Success. And even though the holodisk didn't have the plans we're looking for, it will lead us to someone who does.
Alright, let's just throw down some explosives so that people just blow themselves up. Padding my score. And yeah.
Even though the Polis Massa raid was only a partial success, we finally had a lead on the whereabouts of the Death Star plans, which suited the 501st just fine.
Alright, let's go. Let's go kill some Leias. Yeah. After this, I'm definitely gonna take a break.
With the information gathered on Polis Massa, Vader concluded that the stolen plans had been given to Princess Leia Organa of Alderaan. We weren't surprised. For all their talk of being a peaceful planet, Alderaan had been thumbing its nose at the Empire for years. After a brief and pointless battle, we boarded the ship, the Tantive IV, over Tatooine, began looking for the plans, and waited for Lord Vader's arrival.
Alrighty, let's go.
Lord Vader has tracked the stolen Imperial plans to Ambassador Organa. Retrieve the plans and bring the Ambassador to Lord Vader. Alive. Security mainframes on the bridge before we can gain access to the rest of the ship.
Blowing stuff up never gets old.
Make your way to the engine room and retrieve them from the security terminal on the second floor.
Try not to die.
Disable the turbine to clear our way to the terminal. Take the access code to the tech room terminal.
I always forget that that's a thing.
Those rebels out of the escape pod bays and secure the rest of the ship. Princess Leia must be captured before she can escape.
Alright,
day is
out.
Well done, gentlemen.
I think that calls for another shot. And break.
After Lord Vader took custody of Princess Leia, we all figured it was just a matter of time before she coughed up the plans. Many of us had been unwilling witnesses to Vader's powers of persuasion in the past. The thought of a pampered little princess resisting his terrible will was inconceivable.
Alrighty. Zero death. Yeah. I will be right back. So see y'all in a bit. Alright, I'm back. I have a coin to decide if we're going to be continuing or if we're just gonna stop.
When the Death Star was destroyed, about half of the 501st Legion was still in the hangar getting into their ships. Of those who made it out, another third were caught in the explosion. I'd fought with some of those men for over 20 years. Afterwards, those of us that survived hooked up with a nearby Imperial fleet making a retaliatory strike on the Rebels' base on Yavin 4. It wasn't the best thought-out plan, but we were cut off from our leaders, tired and operating on instinct.
Yeah.
If not for our training, we probably would have never gotten past their orbital defenses.
Cut off from our leaders means all of our leaders are fucking dead.
Attention! All second stage pilots! On deck!
Their heavy transports are trying to go around us. Destroy them before they can jump to hyperspace.
Leave the bomber to me.
Yes. Dodge a little bit of the Death Star remnants.
Destroy them.
That's kind of unfair that they would put a timer and a limited number of forces, but
yeah.
Hostile behind you.
Okay.
Their frigates are harassing our fighters. Show them no mercy. To make the jump to hyperspace, they'll rip right through us. Clear their fighters out and be quick about it. We haven't any time to spare.
Take that bomber down!
Now.
Bomber to destroy their heavy turrets.
This one. fucked are we on troops? We got plenty of them. Coming for you, 30th cousin of Akbar. You know, Admiral Akbar.
Yavin 4 will fall before the day is done.
And drink for the victory. Alrighty.
And so the battle over Yavin came to an end. I'm told we destroyed hundreds of rebel ships that day. Even if it had been thousands, it wouldn't have made up for the Death Star.
Alright. Revenge of the Empire.
By the time we landed on Yavin, whatever shock we'd felt at the destruction of the Death Star had been replaced by anger. For months we'd treated the rebellion like a disobedient child, only to be repaid for our tolerance with treachery on an unimaginable scale. Frankly, I don't remember much of the fighting.
Yeah, I guess we won.
Okay, you all know the mission. The rebel base is located in that ancient temple over there. Our first job is to take the rebel command post located in the ruins of that stone fountain just ahead.
All right.
Command post under the viaduct. Gather your forces.
Alright, let's go into this tough slog.
counterattack could start at any second. Defend the reflecting pool with all your might.
Well defended.
Okay.
Now it's time to breach the security door on the temple. A unique breaching bomb has been left at a point marked on your map. Retrieve the bomb from its drop-off location and place it near the temple security door. The bomb has a 10-second timer, so you better start running as soon as you set it. The rebel command.
All right.
Spirits of our fallen brothers will sleep soundly tonight.
Alright, take a drink for the victory. And
after the battle, the surviving members of the 501st finally caught their breath. The Empire had taken the rebels' best shot and come up standing.
Now, we've only been going for what, 2 hours?
It was our turn to strike.
We could go for longer, I think. I may have to temporarily end the stream and then restart it. But yeah.
No one ever complained about the cold on Hoth. We never felt it. Even though we were blinded by blizzards, we could see the final end of the rebellion in our blaster sights. Was it only a mirage, perhaps? But on that day, on that planet, our blood ran hot with dreams of victory, melting the ice that stood in our way.
Beat it before 8:30.
There is no tomorrow, men. Today we crush the rebellion once and for all. You know the orders. Destroy the shield generator in preparation for Lord Vader's arrival. Next, focus all efforts on preventing the final transport ship from lifting off. We'll begin by taking over their outlook command post. Move out.
Fire!
very preventable cause, I presume. Run into the rocket trick again. I guess they're moving on their own, but not as close as I would like them to be. Having to restart at some point, but yeah, we might not, you know. Takes out that damn snow speeder. Probably didn't, if I had to guess. Alright, let's just try to take this shield generator out.
generator has been reduced to rubble. Ready the ground troops for the assault on Echo Base.
Let's just get this close to Echo Base as possible, and then just wing it, I guess. Guys, to try to take this command post. Landmines. Would be greatly appreciated. A lot easier if the last section of this battle was is all Darth Vader all the time.
Get the rebel!
Mark, we've almost had that rebel scum. An orbital strike beacon has been placed in the hangar for you. Acquire the beacon and place it under the transport. Command will use the coordinates from the beacon to launch a massive attack from above. Failure is not an option. Excellent. Now protect the beacon.
I don't think this is
going to
be done after 8:30, so...
As the rebels fled, the 501st gathered around a burning bunker and let out a cheer that shook the stars. The rebellion was done. The Death Star was being rebuilt bigger than ever. Order had finally returned to the galaxy. In no small part due to the efforts of the fighting men of the 501st.
We continue on. Throughout the entire campaign, or if we stop at another junction. Don't worry, this is I'm the only one who drinks this stuff, so. Alright, 7 deaths, whatever. But yeah. Heads, I will, keep going no matter what. Tails, I'll add a win condition. Alright, heads. We keep going no matter what. So, you know. I'm gonna wait until these credits are over, then I'm gonna take a short break. I'm gonna temporarily shut off the stream. Start a new one so that we can have more videos on the video channel. More vids for the vid god. Alright. Alright, I will be right back, so take this as a pause, those who are still watching, instead of a definite end.